I'm Phyllis Z. I'm a neurologist here at Northwestern Medicine, and I'm also the chief of sleep medicine in the Department of Neurology. Today, we're going to be talking about daylight savings time and also the controversy surrounding daylight savings time. Well, historically, daylight savings was originated in World War I, where the idea was to save energy during the wartime. But it turns out that it really never saved energy, and we just kind of kept it going. I think what's really evolving right now, where there's this hot debate, both from a political, public, and scientific standpoint, is the science that has evolved over the last decade, showing that the transition between standard time to daylight savings time has been associated with adverse health consequences. It's only an hour, right? Why would it make such a difference? And why are the scientists, you know, raising this issue up? It is only an hour. However, it does have much longer effects than that. There's chronic effects of DST that go into the springtime, 3 months into the springtime, also into the summer and into the fall. Basically, you're getting less morning light throughout all those months, and you're getting more evening light. So if you're getting more evening light, what's gonna happen? We're gonna stay up later. We're getting more of that evening light. It's gonna shift our circadian rhythms to a later time, but it does have these chronic lingering effects throughout most of the year. Sleep and circadian misalignment have such adverse effects on metabolism, cardiovascular function, and even may even predict, you know, the development of cognitive disorders as we get older. Heart attacks go up during that transition, as well as the number of car accidents. Yes, absolutely. On Saturday, or maybe even Friday, but Saturday, remember that you have to go to bed earlier by about an hour. Go out and get light. You know, in the morning, that's going to help advance the timing of your rhythms. Get outdoors, get exposure to light, get exposure to exercise during that period. And I would start that transition actually probably on Saturday, if not earlier. Won't be this year, but certainly I think that there is momentum in that direction. Thank you so much, and I really look forward to seeing you next time. This is Dr. Z signing off, wishing you many, many good nights of sleep.